It was a bad time for me. I was going through a painful divorce, and my husband was finally moving out. I knew it was a tough time for my daughter, too. Maybe I didn't realize how tough.
Oh, just forget it. You do.
Diana was such a happy child. I guess I just always thought she'd stay that way. She was no trouble at school or at home. She wasn't a runaway and didn't do drugs. I mean, she just wasn't that kind of kid. But it happened to my daughter. And believe it or not, it could happen to yours. The scary thing is, it can happen to anyone's child. And this is my story.
Have you seen Brian?
Yeah, he was over there, but
right. Diana?
Diana.
Brian? I thought you were gonna call me last night.
I'm sorry, I got hung up.
Well, are we going out on Friday night or not?
Can you excuse me just for a sec? Listen, don't you ever embarrass me like that again.
Embarrass you? Brian, what about me? What is going on here? All of a sudden, I feel like I'm getting the cold.
I tried to let you down easy, but you just don't get it, do you?
Get what?
I don't want to be tied down to just one girl right now, okay?
Okay. I get it.
I'm sorry.
I stopped calling because he found somebody prettier.
Oh, honey.
Anybody else, they would have seen it coming, but not me. I'm too stupid.
Diana.
I really loved him. If he'd just told me what he wanted, what I was doing wrong, then maybe I could have done something or changed in some way.
You don't have to change. You're fine just the way you are.
You always say that. If it was true, then I would be more popular.
Look, sweetheart, I know this is a very painful time for you. But try not to blow it out of proportion, okay? There's going to be a lot of other boys in your life. And you are very pretty.
Yeah, well, you're the only one that thinks that.
Look, you can feel sorry for yourself, but it's not going to help.
Probably the plumber.
Let me get the call real quick, okay? And I'll come back and we'll finish talking. I know you think it's the end of the world, honey, but it's not.
I'm Diana. Would you like to dance?
Yeah.
Definitely know what you're doing, huh?
I love dancing.
So how old are you?
17.
No, you look older.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, how old are you?
23.
Don't you find this crowd a little young?
You think I'm too old for you?
Well, my mother would think so.
Then your mother would be wrong. I'm glad you came to the club tonight, you know?
Thanks. Yeah, I had a good time.
Most of your lips. Do you know how beautiful you are? No, you don't. Not yet. But you will with me. I guess this is good night.
Good night.
Study, huh?
Yeah, well, you're pretty quick yourself.
Well, there's something I want. There's no stopping me.
Oh, look at the time. You gotta go. My mother's gonna be...
Hey, you gotta stop worrying about your mother, okay?
Oh, please, AJ. Please.
I go away for one weekend and this is what I find?
What are you talking about?
You know damned well what I'm talking about. That AJ character was leaving just as I pulled up. And don't tell me he didn't spend the night either.
Look, you went away. I didn't want to be alone.
Oh, now that's a great excuse.
It's the truth. God, you think you'd be happy for me? I finally find someone who likes me.
Well, I don't like him. I don't trust him. And I
look, I don't care what you think, okay? I like AJ and I'm going to see him whether you like it or not.
As long as you're living in my house, you're going to live by my rules. And if you're
not... Fine, then maybe I'll just go live with Daddy. At least he's not always picking on me and telling me what to do.
I couldn't believe it, but several days later, Diana went through with her threat to move in with my ex-husband, Harry. At least, that's what I thought. I found out later she really moved in with AJ. She played on the fact Harry and I weren't talking, so she was able to convince each of us she was living at the other's house.
I'm real proud of you. We should celebrate our official living together.
Why'd you bring me here?
You don't like it?
I'm just so out of place.
Hey, how much do you make with that job of yours at the mall?
$4 an hour.
That'll be $8, sugar.
There you go. Thanks. You know, these dancers can make 30 grand a year, only working a few hours each night.
Yeah, but...
For what?
Looks, body.
Well, you got all that. And then some.
You're serious about me.
Oh, I'm serious. You're a great dancer. Wouldn't this beat slaving at the mall for a few bucks an hour?
Look, money is not that important to me.
Well, I guess we don't have as much in common as I thought. You see, money's everything.
You really want me to be a stripper?
They're not strippers. These girls are entertainers. They're artists. And they're beautiful. But not half as beautiful as you are.
It wouldn't bother you parading around naked in front of all these strangers?
Having other guys want what I have will make me feel great. And you know what? It can make you feel great, too.
I don't think so.
Well... can make us a lot of money. And come on, Diana, think about our future. Me and you.
I just can't.
Hey, don't you want to make me happy? Please. Would you do it for me? Huh? Please, babe, please.
7 weeks. She hasn't been to school for 7 weeks.
I thought you knew.
How would I know? She's been living with my ex-husband.
And he didn't tell you?
Well, we're not exactly on speaking terms, but believe me, he would have called if he knew.
And you don't talk to your daughter?
Of course I talk to her. We talk all the time.
And she never said anything about leaving school?
No. No, she said school was great. Less work than last year.
How's that for an understatement? Did you know Diana had dropped out of school?
How would I know she wasn't in school? You're the one who sees her every day.
I haven't seen her in a month. She told me she moved in with you.
She told me you two were getting along great.
My God. I can't believe she would do this to us.
Thanks. Diana hasn't worked here in weeks. She's with AJ, isn't she? I don't know.
Oh, come on, Lori. I can't believe she'd shut you out of her life.
Well, she did.
Why?
Because she knows I don't approve of what she's doing.
You mean being with him?
Mrs. Moffat, please, I can't. Look, she'd kill me if I told you.
Well, then don't tell me. Just tell me where I can find her.
Okay. But you better be prepared. Look, the Diana you'll find, it's not the Diana we used to know. Oh, yeah.
Get back up there.
Yeah, when she leaves, I will. Diana! Diana, come here!
What's going on?
Who are you?
I'm the owner, and you're out of here.
Well, I'm that girl's mother, and she just turned 18, and you have no right to let her dance in a filthy place like this.
Says who?
She can't be served in a bar until she's 21. She sure as hell can't strip in one.
All the Liquor Commission says is, she can't be in the bar when she's not performing. So when she's not on the stage, she's gone. There's the door. Goodbye. Goodbye!
Portland's best exotic entertainment continues in just a couple of minutes with April Showers. Hang on to your seats. Shooter special.
Most embarrassing moment of my life. I just felt like this little girl again.
Oh boy.
April, this is mine. Jack.
Nice to leave. Nice meeting you, Mrs. Moffat.
I guess I should have warned you that I was coming.
Oh, why didn't you bring Daddy? Oh, what about Grandma?
Stop it.
Why don't you stop it, Mom? Look, I'm 18 now. I can think for myself.
You can think whatever AJ tells you to think. I did some.
Would you leave him out of it?
Okay. If you tell me why, after you met him, you've turned on your family, why you dropped out of school, told your father one thing and me another, and why you are in this horrible place.
I'm here because I want to be. Mom, when I'm on stage, I'm a star. I'm in control.
And off stage, you're not.
I am when I'm away from you.
I never meant to control
you. Right, you were just doing what's best for me. Look, I gotta get back on stage. Look, I don't expect you to understand any of this, so don't try. Just leave me alone. Oh, I can't believe this.
We just want to talk.
We? That's an interesting word coming from you two.
Diana, your mother and I totally agree on this.
United front. Gee, I haven't seen that since I quit piano lessons.
We just want you to come home.
Who's home? It doesn't matter.
Diana, when your mother told me what you were doing, I couldn't believe it. I mean, this kind of thing, it's just not you.
How would you know?
Honey, I'll try to be around more if you'll just come live with me.
You work more than Mom does. Are you that lonely? Is that why you're here? I'm here because... Do I really have to explain everything? Diana, I know you're angry about the divorce, but don't punish us. Is that what you think I'm doing?
Diana.
Let go!
All we want is for you to come home.
I am home. What's she doing here?
Don't sweat it, girl. I'm leaving.
Oh, she had to drop something off.
What, like her earnings for the night?
Yeah, you got it.
He's my automatic teller.
Why'd you give her my jacket?
She was cold. You'll get it back.
Look, AJ, I don't like you lending my things to your sleazy hookers.
Don't talk the way about my ladies, you understand?
AJ, I don't like the way you're making your money.
If it wasn't for them, we couldn't live like we do.
Yo, then let's change the way we live.
You know, stop taking money from them when you make up the difference.
What, now dancing's not good enough for you? You want me to walk the streets, too?
Listen, you know, I know guys who watch you dance who would pay a week's salary for something.
Well, I'm not interested.
You can make a lot more money than you're making now.
Is that all that matters to you?
Now, listen, you're all that matters to me, okay? And someday I want to get married and have kids and live in a big house in the hill. But to do that, you need money and lots of it. Listen, you were born with a beautiful body. And it's made you money dancing. You can even make more money by you.
Being a hooker.
Listen, I told you never use that word again. I'm not giving a Sunday school sermon here, okay? We're talking business. And if I tell you to do something, you're going to do it. Well, I'll toss you back out in the street and you can go running home to mommy. Go back selling cookies at the mall. You understand that?
I'm sorry.
Yes. Don't worry your pretty little head here, okay? Let me take care of business, and everything's gonna be great. Real great.
Tipper, huh?
Hope you're satisfied. He was.
Good. See, referrals are always the best way to build a new business, honey.
Nice to see you, Joe.
Yeah, you back again.
Is this fun for you?
Yeah. And to your right. Put your hair back. Face forward. Okay, next.
First time, huh?
Yeah.
Go to your left.
If you're smart. You won't be back.
Yeah.
No, you're right.
Hey, it's a lot easier to get out now.
All right.
Before things get out of hand. Think about what I said. If you need to talk, numbers are good day or night.
You're right. Turn to your left. Next.
What happens when you don't listen to me?
I listen.
You act like a know-it-all and get busted your first week out.
It was just bad luck.
You know how much I have to fork over to spring you? 750 bills. Who knows if you even worth it?
I'll make it up to you.
Then straight you will. I'm dropping you off in Union Street. And don't come home till you made back every cent. Understand? Get in the car.
Argue with you.
Who do you think you're talking to? Huh?
Ow! Ow! AJ, stop it!
I'm gonna pay a price for coming back to you here!
Stop!
Stop.
Ow!
Oh, God. Don't move. Don't move!
What are you doing? Stop it! What are you doing?
You gotta pay.
Stop it!
I give the orders around here, and all you do is carry them on, understand?
Legal name?
Diana Gale Moffat.
Haven't we met before?
I don't think so.
Okay, a charge against Mr. Treese.
Diana. Assault and battery. Don't worry, honey. It's gonna be okay.
Okay.
That's great.
Oh, thanks, Vincent.
Your sweetheart. Mom's mom's bringing yours.
Okay. Grandma,
here you go.
What a great Christmas we're all together. Yeah, makes me very happy. Okay. I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to a wonderful new year for everybody.
Cheers.
I missed you, Mom.
Mom, I gotta go. I promised Dave I'd bring her a present.
You've gotta go. Well, can't you go later, honey?
Diana? You still have a gift to open?
Ooh, another present. Yay.
Here, hold this. It doesn't say who it's from.
I had your name on it, so I put it under the tree.
Come on, open it up. That's interesting. AJ. Diana, please don't ruin this special day.
Mom, I have to go see April.
Okay, see you tomorrow?
Mom,
after all, it's Christmas and you have
Mom, to I'll be back soon.
Wait a second. Did you like it?
What, the gift?
Yeah. Must you look great in
it? Yeah, I didn't try it on because I don't want it.
You know, that really hurts.
Don't tell me about what really hurts.
Listen, what I did was the worst, and I feel bad about what happened. Would you stand still and let me apologize, please? Listen, my New Year resolution to change all my bad ways, and I want to change, but I need you to help me. I am begging you. Give me a chance. Let me be your number one again. Please. Just don't leave me, all right?
Get up.
I've been so worried.
Well, I'm not 10 anymore. I need your permission to stay out.
How about just calling?
How about just not worrying?
That's impossible. I'm your mother.
Yeah, well, that wasn't my choice.
How dare you talk to me like that?
By the way, I'm not going to court.
You were with him, weren't you? Diana, how could you?
Look, AJ and I talked everything out.
After what he did to you?
He feels bad, but he wants to make it up to me.
And you believe him?
He loves me. And I love him.
Diana.
Mom, I don't want to hear it.
You can't go back to him.
It's my life. And you can't stop me.
AJ is no damn good.
You're just jealous. Because I have someone who loves me and you don't.
Look, I can't take this anymore. If you go back to him, I don't want you coming into this house again, ever. Is that clear? Yes, Mother.
Hi, Mrs. Moffitt. I don't know if you remember me.
How could I ever forget that evening? Diana talks about you all the time. How are you?
Good. Is Diana here? We were supposed to see each other last night.
Oh, unfortunately, we had a big fight last night, and she went back to AJ.
Kidding?
I wish I was.
I bet he had to work in Union Street at the break of dawn.
Union Street?
Yeah, it's too rough down there. You know, I told her to just stick with the escort service.
Escort service?
She told me you knew.
Knew what? April, Knew what?
AJ's Diana's pimp. I'm sorry. I really thought you knew.
California, what do you say?
It's nice.
Maybe we should take the white liner too, you know? Maybe we should take both.
Whatever you want.
That's what's so great about making a lot of money. You can buy two of everything. What's your problem? Smile, lighten up.
Sorry, I'm just tired.
Well, I'm gonna take both of them.
You look tired too, AJ. We both do. Why don't we take some time off?
You mean time off?
You mean like a vacation? Why don't we take our money and go to Mexico or Hawaii? I mean, between dancing and the other, I'm just beat.
Oh. All of a sudden...
It was just a suggestion!
What you made me do.
I'm sorry, I'm just so tired.
You made me at the car.
Hello? Hello? If you're not going to say anything, I'm going to hang up. Diana, is that you?
Tell her I'm sending you home. Tell her.
Diana, say something. Talk to me. Tell me what's happening. Put AJ on.
AJ, are you there? Damn it, are you there?
Yeah, I'm in a depressing motel. You depressing daughter!
If you ever hurt her again, ever.
You can have her. She's not good to me. Wish you couldn't get $10 from the Navy recruit, could you? Are you listening to me?
Mom. I'm coming home real soon, okay? If you'll let me.
Honey, I know when I said that that you couldn't come home, I was angry and I was hurt, and I really didn't mean it. I'm sorry.
I love you.
I love you too.
Diana, sweetheart. Said I could find you here. I'm sorry to come here like this, but I got a very disturbing call from Diana and AJ last night, and I need to talk to you.
Don't apologize. Go on.
Sergeant, I'm telling you that this call was different, scary, and I know she is in physical danger.
Has anybody else heard from her? Your ex-husband, her brother? No. You have no idea where she was calling from?
No.
She's probably taking her out of the circuit.
The what?
Pimps get the prostitutes to work away from one end of the country to the other. Did she make any remark about the weather, smog, sports team?
No.
I was afraid this would happen when she dropped charges against that creep.
That day I brought her in to file the complaint. You'd seen her before, hadn't you?
But she was arrested for soliciting a few months ago. I know her pimp. Everyone in Vice knows Arthur Joseph Treese.
So why would Diana put up with that?
A pimp quickly discovers where a girl's most emotionally vulnerable. He fills her need, gives her a lot of attention. He preys on her lack of self-esteem, makes her feel loved, beautiful.
She was loved. We gave her all of that. I don't understand.
Once he's got her, he keeps her under his control. Threats, beatings.
So what are you planning to do about it?
We have to wait until they resurface.
I don't have time to wait for anyone to resurface.
You sure this is okay with AJ?
Positive. I talked to him and Diane on the phone last night, but he didn't say where they were. Do you know?
I don't know. He never tells me nothing.
The reason I think it's so important is that the other night he mentioned naval recruits.
Well, maybe they're in San Diego.
Do you think that you could go to San Diego and...
Now, Mrs. Moffat.
Please, call me Gail.
All right, Gail, let me explain something. There hasn't even been a crime here. And San Diego is about 1,000 miles outside of my jurisdiction.
So you can't do anything?
If you want, I could call the San Diego police for you.
Well, that's a start. Hello.
Hi. We just heard from San Diego. They found Diana.
Where?
Gail.
What? What's happened?
She's dead.
Because it's quite understandable that at a time like this, you might question how our Heavenly Father could have allowed such a terrible thing to happen. But it's also times like this when the family, friends of Diana, need his mercy and understanding the most.
I'm paying my respects.
Well, consider them paid. Now get the hell out of here. What kind of subhuman are you to come around here at a time like this?
I didn't come here to be insulted. She was my girl and I loved her too, okay? So excuse me.
You're out of here.
Get your hands off me, understand?
I could have killed that punk, I swear.
Pay for what he's done.
That's where we found her. We combed the whole area for clues and didn't find a thing.
Do they know how she was killed?
Body was too far gone for an autopsy. They're assuming she was strangled.
But if they only found fabric and bones, I mean, how can they be sure it was Diana?
We had her dental records sent down.
What about suspects?
I'm sorry, I can't say.
What do you mean you can't say?
All I can say is your daughter's death is under investigation.
And what about A.J. Treese? Was he picked up?
On what charge?
How about possible murder?
Mrs. Moffat, when we find him, we'll talk to him.
Well, I sure hope you're looking for him. Isn't it strange that he reports her missing and then she turns up dead?
Frank, you there?
I'm here.
Forget the NHI. Get over to the DA's office. They got an evidence problem on the Moses case.
I'm on the way. Duty calls. I'll let Sergeant Powell know if anything turns up. And again, I'm really sorry.
Yeah. Thanks. Excuse me. Do you know a girl named April? She's small, very pretty, used to dance at Charlie's. Excuse me, miss. Do you know a girl named April? She's very small and pretty. She used to dance at Charlie's. Diana? Diana? And then I saw this girl, and I swear it was Diana. She got into this car.
Gail, it's not possible.
But she never did identify the body. Gail, she might be alive.
Gail, please, don't do this to yourself. Now, look, you cross-check the dental records. There's no mistake. Dental records don't lie.
What does it mean when the police call something an NHI case?
Oh, NHI, that's old cop talk. Case back to the depression. Stands for no humans involved.
No humans involved?
Refers to the deaths of transients, addicts, prostitutes, people who don't matter.
You mean people like Diana?
I didn't say that.
No, but that's what they called her in San Diego, an NHI case.
Look, I gotta tell you, I didn't even know that they use that expression anymore.
Well, someone does down there.
I don't want to make excuses for some insensitive cop, but sometimes things like this are said out of frustration. Usually, if a murder case isn't solved in the first 72 hours, there's very little chance of ever solving it.
So they just give up?
San Diego is twice the size of Portland. They get a lot of murders.
I know they have other cases, but I don't have another daughter.
I know I was rough on you the first time we met, but I gotta tell you, I really like Diana as a person, not just a dancer.
Has AJ been around here lately?
No. And he won't be. I never really liked him, and he knows why. I don't forgive and forget.
What do you mean?
AJ once told me that if Diana ever left him, he'd kill her. Maybe he was drunk when he told me, but I'm sure he meant it.
Would you testify to that in court?
Be easier to just have him knocked off. Just kidding. Sure, if you ever need my testimony, you got it.
What I want is to see him in jail.
First, you gotta find him.
That's why I'm looking all over for April, the girl who used to dance here with Diana. Do you have an address on her?
Nothing current, but I know her mother has a deli out on Russell. Maybe she could help you.
May I help you?
Are you Mrs. Hill?
Yes.
My name is Gail Moffitt, and I'm trying to get in touch with your daughter, April.
Are you with the police?
No. My daughter was, she was a friend of April's.
I don't know where April is. She stopped being my daughter some time ago. So, if you don't mind, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Mrs. Hill, it's very important that I find your daughter. My daughter was killed, and maybe April can help
you leave. Please?
You mean you have no idea where your daughter is?
No. And I don't care.
I went out tonight for about 2 hours, but I only made $92. I really don't like being out there, but I do it to please AJ because I know he likes it and it makes him happy. I try, but some things he likes me to do are so hard for me. I know he's my man and no one else matters, but Sometimes I'm so unsure of myself. God, I love him. I hope he really knows how much.
Hello?
Hello, Mrs. Moffitt. This is April, Diana's friend. I ran into Charlie.
April, I have been looking all over for you.
I know. Well, I can't really talk right now, but I wanted to let you know that AJ's back in Portland.
Where? April, where is he?
I don't know, but I heard that the police, they brought him in and then they let him go. Listen, I'm sorry, I can't really talk right now, but I'll call back later.
April. 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 Why didn't you tell me he came back and you had him in for questioning?
It just happened, and I was hoping I'd have something more significant to report. We gave him a lie detector test, but it was inconclusive.
So make him take another one.
He refused, and we can't force him. We also can't make an arrest without tangible evidence. Look, I'm frustrated too, but we just don't have enough.
So San Diego's not doing anything either, right?
Well, maybe they're running into the same problems we are. At least give them the benefit of the doubt.
Why should I? They're just giving me the runaround. Whenever I call for a progress report, they say they have nothing. Why? Because they're doing nothing.
Look, they probably have their hands full. They've had a string of murders of young women down there.
And when the young victim is a co-ed, there's a manhunt, task force, media coverage. But when the young victim is a prostitute, it's NHI. No humans involved. So they don't even think of her as a person. To them, she's just a statistic and one that doesn't even count.
Gail.
Who knows? That obnoxious little cop down there probably looks at Diana's death as some sort of a blessing when we finally got her off the streets.
Gail, I don't like the way they're handling things down there either. But now you're being unfair.
You know, maybe I am. But don't I deserve a little fairness, too? Well, I know they can't answer all my questions, but after all, I am the mother of a murder victim. Don't I deserve a little respect? Maybe they don't look at it like that. After all, they consider my daughter to be not even a human being. So where does that make me?
Got a minute?
Yeah.
Been thinking about some of the things you said yesterday.
I'm sorry, I guess I went a little overboard.
I've got an idea that might help. Now, unless we can get a confession from AJ, or some eyewitness turns up, I'm afraid our chances of connecting AJ to Diana's murder are next to nil.
What are you saying?
What I'm saying is, what if we can build a case against them for racketeering? We could put them away for a long time.
Racketeering?
Racketeering in this case is forcing others against their will for illegal purposes.
We're talking murder. He killed my daughter, and I know it.
No, you don't know that. And unless we prove it, the law says he's innocent. And all of our suspicions and all of your anger won't amount to a hill of beans. I came here today to try to help.
I know you did.
Now, you gotta trust me on this. To make this fly, I can't cut any corners. To build a case like this, you have to be very careful. Otherwise, we'll never get to first base.
So, how can I help?
Try to be patient.
I'm helpless. That's the real problem. AJ is walking around free as a bird, damaging other girls every day.
Gail, if you're gonna stay in the middle of this, you gotta keep a clear head. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to talk to this lady. She's good people. She can help.
What is she, some sort of psychologist?
No, she heads an organization called Families of Murdered Children. It's time you talked out some of your feelings.
I can't. It's just too soon. I can't. Maybe in a couple months, but I have to deal with this myself.
Gail, this is something that you have to do now. Think about it.
Thank you.
Mom.
What are you doing here?
Sergeant Powell told us about the meeting. Maybe we should all go. It might help.
I can't. I looked in there and those people seemed so normal. I couldn't bear it if they looked down on us for what Diana was.
She was our daughter.
And my sister. Maybe being here tonight will help us sort through all this.
No one's going to shun us, Gail. We won't let them.
My mother used to say the greatest tragedy in life was to outlive a child. How right she was. One of the things I find so upsetting is that the friends, even family, are getting impatient with me. Like, enough already. Why aren't you over the death of your son?
Gail, would you like to say something?
Just that I can relate to everything you're saying.
That's because some people think we shouldn't talk about our pain. But the most destructive thing is not talking about it and holding everything in. I know it's difficult for you and your family to be here tonight, but...
That's an understatement. The hardest thing for us is not only losing our Diana, but then we have to listen to people say, what's the big deal? She was murdered. She was only a prostitute. That's when it becomes unbearable.
Do you blame yourself for Diana's death?
I guess I do. And I keep trying to think of ways that I could have helped her. I could have saved her, that I could have prevented all of this.
You'll all do that. But you can't blame yourself. And you can't blame your daughter.
Ted's right. No matter what Diana did in her lifetime, she didn't deserve what happened.
That's right. She didn't deserve to die.
It's a long story.
Well, I've got time. Can I buy you something to eat? Yes? Why didn't you tell me you were one of his girls?
Because at that time I wasn't.
But then why did you go back with him?
I can't explain it. He's like a drug. It's like heroin.
Heroin kills.
Well, you know it's bad for you, but you get hooked and you can't get off it.
But you saw what happened to Diana.
Yeah. You know, there's been talk on the street that maybe Randy has something to do with Diana's death.
Randy, you mean the girl that lives with AJ?
Yeah, she always had it in for Diana.
Why?
Jealousy. AJ likes to play one girl against the other. Pimps do that. Anyway, a friend of mine heard Randy say that she didn't have to worry about Diana anymore. And then a little later, Diana was found dead.
But you don't think that she was able to do something like that by herself, do you?
Hell no. Randy wouldn't change her stockings without AJ's permission. I have something for you.
Phaedra knew and took that he'd kill me.
Diana's driver's license. Where'd you get this?
Found it in his things. I thought you'd want it.
This could be something.
Well, in the police report, AJ claims that Diana left the motel to meet a John and never returned. But why wouldn't she have her ID? She never went anywhere without her ID.
Okay, it's still very circumstantial.
Yeah, but the fact that he had her driver's license shows that his whole story's a lie.
Well, maybe, maybe not. But I do have some good news for you. I talked with the DA. He's prepared to roll the dice, see if we can put together a precedent-setting case against our friend, Mr. Treese.
What kind of case?
Well, this is what we're going after. Charging him with compelling and promoting Diana into prostitution. I gotta warn you, it's gonna be tough with Diana being dead. But everybody's prepared to give it all we got. And I want you to know, the only reason this is happening is because you're such a relentless nudge.
I'm going to take that as a compliment. Thanks.
I'm Sergeant Powell with the Portland Police Department. You, sir, are under arrest.
Sir, fact.
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right, anything you say can and will be used against you. You got that, Therese?
You got him? That's great. I know, but it's a start. How badly is she hurt? Yeah, I can be there in 15 minutes.
Dr. Horowitz, urology, please.
All right, she looks a lot worse than she is. She said she really needs to talk to you.
Listen. And he broke my arm, and for a second I thought he was going to kill me. And I called my mom, but she wouldn't come. And you're the only other person that I...
I'm glad you called. I really am. But you can't go on like this. You've got to make a clean break with AJ, because the next time, he will kill you.
Yeah, I realize now he doesn't care about me. He just uses me like he uses everybody else.
I can put you in touch with people who can help. But you have to help us, too.
What kind of help?
Help us get AJ. He was arrested tonight, and you can help. Testifying about all the things you know he did to Diana.
I don't think I can do that.
Why? After what he did to you? Then do it for Diana. Please.
Listen, I don't know what kind of games you guys are playing here, but Diana was what she was.
official you want to be ain't gonna make me a scapegoat, all right?
So you're saying that you had no part in Diana becoming a prostitute?
Diana wanted the life, and I didn't stand in her way.
No. You stood in line depositing her earnings in your savings account.
Is that what my bank statement says?
I have a copy here of Diana's employment records with Soft Touch Massage. You've heard of them.
Yeah, I know she worked there for a while.
Diana listed you as a reference on her job application.
Listen, she wanted somebody to watch for her. You know, she showed up and all.
Yeah, the owner of the company said that you used to drive her to and from her dates.
I was being a friend.
And you had no idea that this out-call massage service was really a call girl operation?
No, I didn't.
Well, you've led a very sheltered life, Arthur. I can understand where maybe you couldn't put two and two together.
Maybe I didn't want to.
Well, because you loved her, right?
That's right. I did love her. And I took care of her. I mean, the thought about the guys having sex with her made me sick.
So you're not denying that you knew she was a prostitute?
All I'm saying is that I didn't make her one.
But you kept her one.
What the hell I did? Come on.
You beat her up when she wanted to get out.
That's a lot of crap.
Hey, she filed an assault and battery charge. I got the report right here.
The report also says that she dropped those charges.
Oh, Arthur, you're beginning to make me lose my patience.
All right, so I beat her up a few times. I bet half the dudes you work with bang around their old ladies.
Why'd you hit her, Arthur? Because she wanted out of the game? Because you were afraid that your money machine was going to dry up?
You got it all wrong, man. It's just the opposite. Look, I hate her going out with other guys. I hate her even looking at other guys. But she had this need. I mean, one guy was enough for her. And I couldn't take it. That's why I beat her up a few times. And I know I shouldn't have, and I'll never forgive myself for that. I won't. But you gotta believe me. I did love her. I did.
I do believe you, Arthur. I also believe that Elvis is alive and that my hand was abducted by aliens. Maybe next time, put him on film. At least that way maybe we can get an Academy Award for him.
Hello?
Yeah, I got bad news and bad news. AJ got out on bail, and a couple of hours later, April let the DA know that she was dropping the assault charges.
God, does that mean she's not going to testify?
That's sure how I read it.
Let me know if anything changes, okay?
Yeah.
Bye. April?
Please, Mrs. Moffat, I know what you're thinking.
No, you don't. Because all my thinking right now is very confused.
Well, AJ made bail this morning. When I found out, I was just too scared to leave my apartment.
So that's why you're out here with a broken arm?
I had to show him I'd come to my senses.
Look, AJ once talked Diana into dropping the assault charges she filed against him. So I know how persuasive he can be.
He's not just persuasive. He's dangerous.
I know that, too. But you know why he's so dangerous? Because girls like you and Diana give him so much power. If you can't give up, you just can't. I once told Diana that if she ever went back to AJ, that she could never come back home again. And you know something? She never did. Don't let that happen to you, please.
I just don't think I'm strong enough to make it on my own just now.
Filing the charges against AJ took a lot of strength. If you got the strength, the real question is, do you have the courage to use it? Do you?
Check.
Gail? Gail. There's been some sort of delay.
Well, what does that mean?
Who knows?
I keep thinking about all the things I could have said to April.
Now, don't go start blaming yourself, Gail.
Do we have a chance?
Hey, I don't know exactly what's going on, but let's not start to panic before we have cause. I'll get back to you as soon as I know something, okay?
Okay.
Quiet, please. Mr. Treese, I have been advised by your attorney that as a result of negotiations today between himself and the district attorney, you will be entering a no-contest plea to the charge of compelling prostitution. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Do you understand that if this case went to trial, the state would have to prove that Diana Moffat was, in fact, a prostitute, that you, in fact, did receive earnings she derived from selling sex, and that she continued in prostitution against her will? And the state would have to prove each of the elements beyond any reasonable doubt to make 10 of 12 jurors agree you were guilty? Do you understand? Mr. Treese, do you understand?
Yes, I do.
Mr. Treese, will you please tell the court the reason behind your change of plea?
Because of new developments.
Speak up, please.
I just thought it would be better for me.
Before I adjourn and set a date and time for sentencing, the people's attorney has asked if I would allow the mother of Diana Moffat to address the court. Is that something you still wish to do, Mrs. Moffat?
Yes, Your Honor. First of all, I'd like to say that I don't understand or plan to second guess the decision to reach a plea bargaining arrangement with the defendant. But regardless of what the legal charges were against Mr. Treese, when it comes to sentencing, I would hope you would take into consideration the fact that that young man did indeed kill my daughter. I don't know whether it was by his own hand or by one of his lackeys or by a total stranger, but he did kill her. He led her into a life she would never have known. And he brought her a death that no child and no parent could ever even imagine. So, in the interest of justice and all the other girls in our community, like my Diana, I ask you, Your Honor, to punish this man to the fullest extent of the law. Thank you.
The great news is we've set a precedent here. The DA just told me he's now ready to go after another half dozen pimps.
Less than a year? That's it?
I guess that's the best we can do, right?
Well, for now, but I won't give up if you won't.
It's a deal.
See ya.
Okay. I'll see you back home.
Okay.
And you. Thank you.
To talk.
I'm sorry, we're closed.
Mrs. Hill, I need to talk to you. It's important. Please.
I've already told you we have nothing to talk about.
Yes, we do. And I promise I won't take up too much of your time, but there's something you have to hear before it's too late. You have a very troubled, yet basically a very decent daughter named April, whom you have disowned for totally logical reasons. Some of the things she's done with her life are terrible. And no parent wants to know that her child has behaved like that. I didn't. And I drove my daughter out of my house, too. But my daughter is dead. And there's no way she's ever going to come home again. But you still have a chance.
You don't understand. I tried everything with that kid. I did. She broke my heart.
Believe me, I know that feeling. And I also know how painful this all must be for you. But the most painful thing of all is to wake up one morning to discover that your child is dead. Every day, every hour, I torment myself with the things that I could have said, maybe should have done. I've gotten to know your daughter a little bit, and she reminds me very much of my Diana. Don't drive her away like I did. If you want to save your daughter, you have to be persistent. You have to tell her that you'll forgive her. And you have to tell her you love her. And if she does get in trouble with the law, you have to work with the police. Just never give up on her. Because then she'll give up on herself and it's all over. Don't let that happen. I'm sorry. I've just carried on like some crazy lunatic. Huh? I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. Even if I wanted to start with April again, I don't have any idea where she is.
I do. She's out of my car. Should I ask her to come in? There's still a part of me that can't believe she's gone. Sometimes when it's late at night and I can't sleep, I go down on the street and I look at the girls. Sometimes one will turn my way and for a split second, I swear it's her. Of course, it never is. It's no longer just another prostitute I see on that street corner. It's somebody's daughter.